Welcome to another 5-pound challenge where we try to feed the whole family for just under 5 pounds. Today, we're making chicken under a brick with some mushrooms, leek, sweet hot cabbage, and some hand-cut chips. Let's do it. First, we deal with the potatoes because they take the longest. I mean, this feeds the whole family already. So for the purpose of demonstration, we're just gonna do a tiny bit to not waste. Cut this in half. I like my chips quite thick with the skin on. Now, you can double fry them, triple fry them. That's up to you. We're going to do this in the oven just for the sake of smell. Now, to increase crispiness, we need to increase the surface area. So we shock this in boiling water. And you cook until they have just softened a tiny bit, about 7-8 minutes. While that's cooking, we prep our Hispi cabbage. We remove the wilted outer leaves and we cut them into wedges. Add them to a tray. We season with salt, pepper. I mean, if you have some spices in your cabinet, throw them in. Bit of olive oil to help even cooking. And this is ready for the oven when we have 20 minutes left. With Hispi cabbage, the quicker you cook them, the more nuttiness you retain. And if you cook it for too long, it just tastes like regular cabbage. So we set this aside while we prep our mushrooms. 6 portions, 4 mushrooms. What do you do? Well, you slice them. Very simple. We remove the stem. And for the sake of color, you can scrape the dark bits because they have no flavor. But because we're gonna slice and saute them, I'm not even gonna bother. So, very simple, we make strips. Don't make them too thin because you have to factor in the shrinkage. And we prep some leeks. We remove one tough outer leaf and we slice it in half. Now, while this is still intact, we give it a quick wash. Now, we slice them quite thin. Perfect. Now, after 8 minutes, we drain the potatoes. First, transfer them to a bowl for some seasoning and for some rough treatment. We add a generous amount of salt and we toss. You don't want to break them, but you want to damage the surface slightly to increase the surface areas of the chips. And that's gonna give us more surface area for browning. I mean, if you really have the time, you could put them on a grater and damage the surface a bit more, but that's a weekend project. Now, take a tray, vegetable oil, or any high smoke point oil, and chips go in. You definitely want to form one even layer. Now, this goes into a preheated oven at 220 for 40 minutes. After the first 20 minutes, we're gonna turn it once and add the Hispi cabbage to the oven. Now, let's prep our chicken. Now, the whole point of chicken under a brick is that we're maximizing the skin contact with the hot pan. And in order to do that, we have to bone out the chicken. First, we separate the thigh from the drum. You wiggle until you found the joint, just here. You cut through. Now, we have 6 portions. First, let's deal with the thighs. You find the bone and you literally cut around it on either side. Once you get deep enough, push your knife through. Now, if this were some French bird, I would remove the sinew to make them less chewy, like this. But most budget chicken are rarely chewy. I probably would not bother. All right, we have our 6 portions. We season very generously with salt. No black pepper, just because I want them to really, really crisp up the skin. And I don't want the black pepper to be burning for 30 minutes. Hot pan, bit of vegetable oil to get it started, or any high smoke point oil. Chicken goes in, skin side down. We season the other side with salt. And because this side's not gonna burn, a very generous amount of black pepper. Now, the brick. I don't have a brick, but I have a cast iron pan. And in order for the bottom to not catch, we're gonna wrap this in tin foil. We oil, and this thing goes directly on top. You can hear the difference in the sizzle right away because suddenly everything is in direct contact with the hot pan. This is what's gonna maximize the Maillard reaction, the browning, protein reacting to high heat, making the chicken taste meatier. Now, we're gonna cook this for 30 minutes at medium-high heat. The reason being, we do not want the chicken juices to soak the skin, so we want a high enough heat to turn all those liquid into steam, to evaporate away from the pan. And make sure you have a channel for the steam to escape, otherwise you're just making steamed chicken. Now, after 20 minutes, we flip our potatoes. As you can see, they're already taking on some wonderful colors. And now, they go in together with the Hispi cabbage wedges for another 20 minutes. And now, we saute our mushrooms and leeks. Hot pan, vegetable oil, mushrooms go in. We first evaporate most of the water content in the mushrooms, and then we'll brown them. To help them get started, we salt, black pepper. You see the steam coming out? Still evaporating. That's perfect. Just to have more control, I'm gonna set this aside, and we saute the leeks. Leeks go in. Salt, pepper. If you really want to go the extra mile, you can take some chicken fat from the pan, but I'm not bothered. Once again, we're evaporating the water content to concentrate the flavors and particularly the sweetness of the leeks. So you want to adjust the heat accordingly because the pectin, the sticky element of the leeks, makes it very easy to burn them. You see, there's no more steam coming out from this one. That's when you know the chicken skin is frying in its own fat. Perfect. And that's it. All right, after another 20 minutes, we have our leeks and mushrooms. We have our nutty and brown Hispi cabbage and our oven roasted thick cut chips. Let's check on the chicken, shall we? We remove the tower that we built. Carefully remove this. Now it doesn't look magical yet, but wait till you see the other side. It's beautiful. Incredible. Wow. Let's plate one, shall we? We have some subpar mushroom art. Now remember, I wanted to add some chicken fat. On top. And of course, we have our Hispi cabbage and some lovely thick cut chips on the side. This is chicken under a brick for 6 people. I really hope you enjoy. Beautiful though, huh? Woo!